expectations versus standards. Expectations are external by nature. Now, you probably won't agree with that at first, but when I explain it, you'll understand very shortly. Standards are internal, meaning you are in control of them. Expectations mean this. Expectations without implementations equals frustrations. How many times have you expected your spouse, your loved one, your partner, or a coworker or boss to do something, but they didn't implement what you wanted them to do, and you were left frustrated? Happens all the time. Another way to consider this is consider the laws of the land, meaning your driver's license. You know when you take your driver's test what the standards are. If you speed in the school zone and you get pulled over, you can't say, well, officer, I was expecting that you'd let me go. No, the standard is, or the law, is if you speed in a school zone, you're getting a ticket. So there's no shock, there's no surprise. Expectations without implementations equals frustration. It's how in our life we get frustrated why other people don't do what we ask them to do, is we expected them to. It wasn't a standard. Let me show you how this worked in my own life. I'm the youngest of five. I grew up, I have a saintly mother, love her to death. But on the way to school, we were always late. It's like, get your shoes, get in the car, we're blowing through stop signs, we're always late. And I swore, when I was an adult and I had children of my own, I would never do that. My kids are in first and third grade, and I realized I'm doing it every day. Get your backpacks, you're old enough to feed yourself, get breakfast. And I'm frustrated every single day. I thought there's got to be a better way. My wife and I, we sat down and said, okay, what's the standard of our house? So we sat down and said, okay, here's the standard. Daddy's going to work at 8 in the morning. School starts at 8:15. If you are in the car at 8, you don't have to walk, I'll drive you. But if you are not in the car at 8, then you have to walk yourself. We only live about a half mile away from school, and they've never walked by themselves. We've always either walked with them or I've driven them on the way to work. So the next morning, I go downstairs at 7:45. They're sitting in the living room, shoes on, shoes tied, backpack, jackets. They're ready to go. They've already had breakfast. And it hit me. I thought, the standard was they knew the consequence, and they accepted the reward. The reward is you get to drive with Daddy to work. The consequence is you got to walk to school. So when my kids started living this standard that we set and that they agreed upon, the next morning they got up a little earlier. And I said, you know what? You guys are getting up earlier. Do you want to go hiking in the morning? And they're like, Dad, can we do that? And I said, absolutely. You're obeying the standard. You get the reward. So we started getting up at 7 and then 6:30. We started hiking. We went to different towns and started hiking before school. And they had an absolute blast. So in your relationships, to create a standard, you need to write down what the reward is and what the punishment is. Then there's no surprises. If someone makes a mistake, you know the reward, you know the punishment, there's no arguments. I don't recommend doing a ton of standards, maybe 3 max in a relationship at first, until those standards become natural. If you raise your expectations for yourself or for someone else, and they or you do not implement, you end up raising your frustration. You don't get a better result. But if you raise your standard, put a better reward for yourself, you will get a better result. And that is the definition of expectations versus standards.